Hello everyone. Today I'm going to give you a brief introduction about SAS, that what is SAS actually and what it stands for, what is the use of SAS actually in different fields. So SAS is basically stand for the Statistical Analysis System, a software system for data analysis and report writing. So what SAS, how actually SAS works? So SAS works through the computer programming, and it can store data value, it can retrieve data from multiple resources and in multiple format as well. Like if you have a data in Excel format, in text format, in CSV files, so that can be retrieved and that can be, you know, changed into the SAS format, and further you know, changes can be done. And SAS same time can modify data, like if some format change or any additional changes is needed, that can be done through the SAS programming. SAS can compute simple and complex statistical analysis, and then can draw like table, figures, and you know, listing, and also it creates reports. Reports can be in either text file or PDF or Excel, whatever is needed. So it's a very powerful programming tools that is used in different fields. So use of SAS programming, if we see that SAS is used in data management, like in so many fields, in advanced and simple analytics, I can say if you need it, it's used for the multivariate analysis, in business intelligence and criminal investigation and predictive analysis as well. So these are the some, you know, broad use of the SAS programming. So if you see the workflow of the SAS programming, so this is our raw data that you can get from any field. If you have you know, data from clinical laboratories, so it can be in a different format. If data from marketing or, you know, in finance sector, whatever, you know, the raw data is coming from, and it can be in the multiple format. So what SAS does actually, so when you program writing, you know, SAS statement, it can change, you know, it changed the SAS, this raw data into a SAS data sets. And SAS data sets can be, you know, proceed further using the PROC steps. Various procedure statements can be used to analyze and change and format, you know, and tabulate the data sets. And then finally, a results and analysis report can be generated, and final reports with, you know, a proper labeling, a proper, you know, headlines and footnotes can be generated. And so this is the basic workflow of how a raw data can be used to generate a final report for any study. So main thing I just wanted to remind you that we should always remember that SAS enable you to perform data entry, retrieval, and data management. SAS is also used for the data manipulation, like if there is any format change, as I said, is needed, or any imputation is needed at some point. And SAS can be used for warehousing and data mining if something is need to dig and find. And SAS is also for statistical and mathematical analysis. And for report writing and graphics, as I said, it can be used for, you know, table, listing, and figures to generate, you know, from raw data. And quality improvement, the data quality can be improved, formatting and size and text, whatever is needed. And it can be used for the application development and web reporting. So this is a brief introduction about the SAS. Thank you very much for watching.